In this video, we're going to be looking at undercoating our models by hand. Now, as you can see here, I've got the model built and he's ready to get going, but he will need an undercoat. And we're going to start with an undercoat, but this will be using a base paint because it will give it a nice smooth coverage for those other colours to be applied. Now, depending on which method you're going to go with, if you're going to go with classic method, we recommend using a Baden Black or Corax White to base coat it with. And if you're going to go for the contrast method, then you want to look at something like Wraithbone or Grey Sear. But for this particular model, I'm going to be using a Baden Black. So the first thing we'll do is give the pot a quick shake. Now you want a brush that's appropriate to the size of the model. So for this one, I'm going to be using a large base brush because it's slightly larger and it just means I can get more paint on my actual brush itself. So all you're going to do is load up the brush and apply a little bit to your palette. Now, this is key part here. We need to thin it down ever so slightly because we don't want it to be too thick and goopy and clog up all those details. So as you mix it on the palette, you want to see just a little bit of that white of the palette showing through, not too much. So you can see just a little bit of translucency there, so that's perfect. So all I'm going to do now is make sure my brush is nice and loaded. Then we're going to start actually applying it to the model. Now, when doing this, you want to start on those recesses first and work actually to the raised areas after. And you will notice on the first coat, because we'll be doing two coats of this, that you will see some of that grey plastic showing through. Don't worry about this, because that will disappear after the second coat. With that first coat now dry, we're going to apply the second coat. Well, this will actually remove any of those streaky bits that you've probably seen on the first coat. But always during this process, just double check the thickness of your paint so it's not too thick and goopy. And there we are with those two base coats now applied and dry. This model is now undercoated and ready to have other colours added to it.